So, welcome to Pax Europiana here from Austria and Heldenplatz. We have in Austria a government between the conservatives led by Kurz and the Greens led by Kogler. And that's the role model also for Germany. Of course, added by the liberals, it's the best combination possible. And so how to get this done? How to copy the Austrian model for Germany and avoid a kind of pro-Russian coalition led by Olaf, the friend of Gerhard, his mentor, who is working for Putin? Because that's the line of authority. Putin, Schröder, Olaf Scholz. So that would be really very bad for European security. It would be very bad for everything. It would be a guaranteed success for Nord Stream 2 connection, and that would of course lead to this 55 billion new Russian dirty carbon being burned in the European Union. And I hope the Greens are not in for it. And so how basically to make this Olaf coalition fall? It's to make an offer to the Greens that a CDU-led government will make this Nord Stream 2 to the German Zwentendorf. Finished technically, but never operationally. Short explanation, Zwentendorf is the Austrian nuclear power station. We made a referendum against it. Was won in a close margin in 78, and it was still today, it's like a kind of a building and works as a museum to explain how nuclear power could work in Austria, but it never worked. And if you take climate change seriously, and I think the Greens are, and the FDP are, they say, the CDU is, they say. So how to bring this kind of 55 billion cubic every single year of dirty Russian gas into the European Union is absolutely crazy. And the only reason why it happened, let's not forget, is because the Schröder backdoor policy to Putin to stop the tanks in Delbatseve at the Ukrainian battlefields has asked the price, and Merkel promised to Schröder and then to Putin to finish this pipeline. And so it will be finished if this line is continuing. So how to stop it? It's quite simple. Get another CDU leader who is ready to stop it. And this is Röttgen. Laschet is a man of the energy sector. He's a RWE man. So let's get Röttgen to power in the CDU. Let's contain the CSU and their pro-Russian policy. Let's make sure that the business links via Kubicki and the North towards Nord Stream 2 is a little bit subdued in the FDP. And let's make sure that the Greens get the one big thing Germany can do, not give an operation license to Nord Stream 2. And obviously that is hindering then a lot of other negative developments like these direct links, and then Ukraine can join the European Union, Kosovo can join the European Union, and Gerhard Schröder and Putin, they can invite whatever, Olaf Scholz can be ambassador in Petersburg, yeah, and have a career in Nord Stream 2 as well. Fine for me. And in Rosnav, take the place of Mrs. Kneisel. I don't wish him anything bad, but we don't need a German chancellor controlled via Gerhard Schröder and all this soft influence and hard influence from the Russians. No, Röttgen is pro-American, Röttgen is against Nord Stream 2, Röttgen is pro-Kosovo, pro-Ukraine, and the Greens really know how to work with him. It's very good. Laschet can run for Prime Minister of North Rhine-Westphalia, very good. He can even stay CDU party chairman for some time, yeah? But it's time for a new offer to the Greens. Do you really want to, like, without a real kind of a serious offer, go into the opposition? That will be disastrous. The CDU is not a party to renew in the opposition, no. It will be disastrous. There will be a lot of infighting for all this guilt and, you know, the failure, blame game, and it will be very bad. It's much better to stay on, soldier on, and get this dirty deal of Nord Stream 2 between Putin and Schröder, get it finished. Get it off the table, destroy it, kaput. That's the best way forward. And I call for this. We also don't have a perfect government, don't get me wrong. I have 1,000 things here Kurz and Kogler could do better. But this idea that you really make an agreement between the conservative business circles of a society, the Mittelstand, and the green reformers, that you basically raise the energy prices, do the energy transition, but cut taxes on the working middle class and on the companies. And that's, I think, acceptable. Let's pay more for energy, hard it is, but not for Russian energy. Let's cut Russian energy, let's make energy more expensive, let's also make the energy transition, fine for me, but for a lower corporate taxation of 20%, like it will come here, 21, and hopefully 20 in Germany. That is really the way for progress. And let's make Russian energy, let's fade it out. But let's not bring a new pipeline from Russia. And that's total nonsensical. And so the German coalition can be built around these topics. And that's, of course, changing everything. So less Russian power, less Russian money laundering. And that's really the way forward. And in Austria, it didn't work very well. You know, our Greens are not as good as the German Greens. Our whatever Kurz's party is not as good as the CDU, and our Liberals are too weak for the same. But at least we have it already. And it would be a tragic mistake to go now back to this Olaf social democracy. And that would be very anti-American, very pro-Russian, very pro-Nord Stream 2, global tax coordination, harmonization, higher taxes, meaning it on everybody, and no relief for the companies. It would be the decline and the start of the decline, the decade of stagnation, if now the wrong decision will be taken in Berlin. Good. That's my call. Significant changes. And by the way, get Manfred Weber to Bavaria and Söder to the Ministry of Interior, because he is as guilty as anybody for the mess we are in today. And he should not be staying on as the Prime Minister of Bavaria, because his performance is miserable. And give him the Ministry of Interior and build him into the coalition. Don't let him hang out in Bavaria like a loose cannon. Good. So far from now. Thanks a lot for listening. More to come. Bye.